All right, so maybe you're at your bait and tackle store, you're looking for rod holders, you're cruising through Amazon, and you look at the price, and you have a little sticker shock, and you're just thinking, those are just plastic pipes, I can make those myself. Or maybe you've bought those before, and you have a bait caster reel. Well, on the back of those bait caster reels are little knobs, and your bait casting reel and rod won't fit in there. Well, I got good news for you. You can make them themselves. I'm gonna show you how. Stick around, I'm gonna show you how to make a high quality DIY rod holder for your bait casting reels. Let's do this. All right, you're gonna need a few tools and materials. First, you're gonna need an inch and a half piece of PVC pipe. I've cut these out to a foot each, and you can buy a 10-foot piece of pipe that's $6 at Lowe's. You need a drill with a half inch drill bit, hacksaw, heat gun, some type of bottle. It doesn't have to be a wine bottle. What we're looking for is the flare. That's how you're gonna flare out your pipes. You need an orbital sander and a tape measure and a vise. You'll need that to hold the PVC pipe when you're cutting it with the hacksaw. All right, let's hop to it. So this one's fairly easy. What you do, you grab your heat gun, and you're gonna start applying heat to the outside and inside of your pipe. And whenever it gets warm enough, you're gonna flip it over and pop it down in your bottle. Now this will create the flare. And if it's not flared enough, you heat it up as much as you need it to, and just continue to apply heat as you spin this around the bottle. All right, I'm gonna speed this process up so you don't have to wait around for 45 seconds. All right, the measurements are pretty simple. Go an inch and a half over and make two dots on the top. Then from those dots, go an inch and a half down and mark a line on the other side. Do the same thing. Then connect those with a line. Then what we're gonna do is go 1 inch down, make a line here. And this is going to be the piece that is cut out. So as you can imagine, you're taking the hacksaw after you put this in the vise. You're gonna cut down this line, take it out of the vise, move it to the side, and cut at an angle, and this piece will be completely gone. All right, the part's fairly easy. Just put it in the vise. Tighten it up pretty good. Take a hacksaw, cut along this line. All right, now that you cut the vertical line, you'll now cut the horizontal line at an angle. So you take it out of the vise, flip it over, tighten it up. The key here is to make sure that you connect where you left off. This is your front. After you cut it, turn it around. This is for your bait caster nodule on the back of your rod. So find the center, make a mark, go down 1.5 inches, make a mark, drill your hole with a half inch drill bit. Now you have your hole cut, find the edges, run a line, cut this out with the hacksaw on the vise. And there you have it, your DIY rod holders for your bait casting reel and rod. When you're done, you can paint them up, attach them to your kayak crate. This is my kayak crate, I love it. If you wanna learn how to make this kayak crate, I actually have another video that shows you how to make the kayak crate with the rod holders. Check it out in the cards above. But here's the finished product. So after you have it all said and done, you have a rod holder here. You could put mini bungees on it, drill a hole. This is if you're in rough waters, you can connect your rod and reel so it doesn't leave it. It's really simple. Take your bait caster, stick it in, and if you see on the bottom, you see right there, the knob connects the back end. Now, if you love this type of thing, love kayak fishing, love DIY fishing, love all things fishing, please hit the subscribe button, hit the bell notification, smash that like button, and I will continue to serve videos just like this up to you. All right, now stop watching videos and get out there and start fishing. See ya.